Hi, this is Linda Shea reporting from BP's Upstream Learning Center in Houston. Joining me today is Clena Abuan, Senior Technology Associate with BP. She recently spoke at an IEDC Drilling Engineers Committee Technology Forum about how to foster innovation in the oil and gas industry. Clena, thank you for being here.
Thank you, Linda. It's great to be here.
So in your presentation, you mentioned the creative learning spiral. Can you explain to us what that is and how we can use it in our industry to bring about innovations?
So Mitchell Resnick is a research director at the MIT Media Lab, and he came up with this framework called the creative learning spiral, which is around thinking about how to move through creativity. And so it's got five parts to it. It's centered around imagination, and it goes through create, play, share, reflect, and goes back to imagination. But the interesting thing about it is actually it's not linear, and that when you get back to imagination, you're actually expanding upon the ideas you had initially. So it's actually an evolving way of thinking. And so the way that this could be useful in the oil and gas industry is you might look at using it in anything where you might need to improve processes or if you're looking for innovation, because really creativity is needed in anything where either you're looking for big, bold new ideas, which is usually what people think, or even in areas where you just need small process improvement.
So what are some of the key benefits of using the creative learning spiral, and are there any challenges associated with using it?
So I think that some of the key benefits are that you could easily see how providing somewhat of a framework or a process around creativity would help it move from this kind of ambiguous thing into something that allows you to move a little bit more nimbly or agilely through a process. You turn it into a process, essentially, but it's still lightweight enough where you don't have too much involved so that you could actually take ideas and move from point A to point B and actually take ideas, which sometimes can be very difficult, to move into more tangible things and turn it into an actual thing. Some of the challenges, though, that people might find is because it's meant to be a framework and lightweight, it can be challenging finding the balance between putting some structure around it, but not too much structure, because sometimes then putting too much structure around it then hinders the whole point of creative thinking.
So in your presentation, you also mentioned an initiative at BP to develop a model that could possibly predict the probability of a safety incident occurring. Can you tell us about the development of that model and what are some of the results you've seen?
Safety is really core to our business. We have some really strong safety programs, and we've been exploring the idea, can you use the data that we've got to predict whether there's a probability of injury and use that as a tool to mitigate or maybe even eliminate personal injury in the workplace? So we started with a very small proof of concept with a third-party vendor and some of our colleagues in the oil and gas industry and began to explore this idea, and we saw some initial success. And so what we're doing now is we're exploring this further, expanding it past a smaller proof of concept and looking at not just whether it's possible, because we've seen now that it is possible to a degree to model this, but also how do you incorporate it into our operations? So really understanding how you take the insights from such a tool and operationalize it. And so this is really something that the oil and gas industry in general could benefit from. And we're really excited that we're able to collaborate, and we're open to collaborating with others as well.
So how do you think innovation and creativity can help companies to respond to the big crew change that's underway?
So I think that innovation and creativity are probably going to be a big part in helping us transition successfully through the big crew change. It's really important to capture the experience and ideas that people have. And we have these tools now that could potentially help. I'm sure people have had ideas that maybe at the time technology couldn't support, but now revisiting those ideas, maybe they can be done. And so, but the thing is, we need an outlet to have those voices rise to the top. So for example, maybe people could look at using informal forums or platforms for people to kind of talk about these ideas. One example, we have something called a Da Vinci Web forum, where we actually put out open calls to all parts of the business. And sometimes we center around particular ideas or issues that we're looking to address, and people throw out ideas, and it's a way for people to collaborate and come together around certain ideas.
Well, thank you so much, Clena, for being here and for sharing your insights with us.
Thank you. I've really enjoyed speaking with you again.
And thank you, viewers, for joining us on drillingcontractor.org.